Hello, and welcome to Perfectly Mediocre. Today we're taking a look at the demo for a game called Brave Village. In this game, it's called a casual adventure simulation game. You manage a small village and explore dark mines. Upgrade villagers and buildings, craft equipment and food, defeat evil goblins, and reclaim lost lands. I'm going to go ahead and do a new game and kind of start from the beginning so you can see like the basics of how it works. We do have some very basic tutorials to help us figure out the things that we're doing. It's all very, very, very simplified, and honestly, I'm here for it. So we have two enemies, the goblins and skeletons, but they started out with the basics. You select your tool and then you choose the thing that you want to collect, and once you've done that, you go ahead and click this and you get some coin for doing that. So next we need to collect two stones, so we move on to that, and you can also use the number keys as well and go ahead and choose those. Now it does appear that you can't queue anything up. That's something that I would love to see in the game, but it does like leave a little thing here, and then that will grow back in the same position as you see right there. And we need to collect another wood, so we're going to go ahead and do that. And I think the little like hand waving here is to kind of indicate that that is the next thing that we want to be doing. So it's kind of like a priority. So we're going to go ahead and upgrade our house, which is now under construction. And if we look over here, we have another area to unlock. We need 60 coin to do that, which, wouldn't you know it, we just got that. So we're going to go ahead and unlock area 2, and that gives us 100 coin. And this is where we end up encountering our first enemy, the goblin, and we need our sword for that. And we go ahead and get the goblin. We do have someone down here as well, you may notice, and it's a little shop where we can purchase items. Now if we look here for the merchant information, well, the battle thing is very easy. My kind of battle, I don't have to do anything, I'm literally not touching. It's doing its own thing. That might not be what others are looking for. I've also noticed that defeating the goblin seems to leave behind the other enemy. And I guess that these are our two people, and we can now choose between them. So as Jack, I can tell him to go ahead and defeat him, and then switch back over to, okay, I think I chose the wrong one. Okay, now on Jack, I can tell him to go here. Well, we need some things to do that first, so tell him to chop a tree or something. And then we'll go to you. I think we just don't decide who actually does it. It's kind of just doing it. And then I think after you finish that, we're gonna try to get you to do, yep, get some stone. There you go. You guys can get this. Oh, we need 3 wood. Well, thank you for getting that. Okay. And they're going to bring it back over here to the storehouse and drop it off. Alright, now you are available by the looks of it, so I'll have you get another wood. And it does say to gather 2 tree also, so might as well get another tree going. Okay, the next thing is to eliminate 1 skull. Now, I had the skull when I had played mine, when I was playing originally. I'm not seeing it here. I think I have to take care of another goblin, get the skeleton, and then deal with the skull afterward. That seems to be the deal there. Can we have someone else? Can we, select you? Okay, you're still gathering stuff, I guess. Oh, you're gonna come over here and get that skull. Thanks so much for that. You're awesome. Can I have you go ahead and get that? Okay. I don't know where you're going with that skull. watch you carefully. Okay. That didn't eliminate it. How do we eliminate a skull? Oh, wait. We got another situation here. Okay, we want to upgrade the second villager house. So we're still working on that. I think I'm going to... Oh, I need more stone. Okay. We're going to have to work on some stone. But first, somebody's got to deal with this. And then I'll have the other deal with the stone. Where did you go? Oh, you're getting some rest. Fair enough. I have been keeping you pretty busy. Okay, that looks like a normal skull and not the black skull. So maybe that finally worked. Okay. So there must be two types of skull. Interesting. Okay, let's get you both working on the stone so that we can finish upgrading that second house. And then somebody's got to work on a tree. These trees are hopping for attention, so we'll get you over there. Oh, more stone. Hey, we're upgradable. There we go. It's under construction. And if you have a tool selected, I really like that all you have to do is right-click and it deselects the tool. So, very simple. Like, super simple kind of, tools to use. Very minimal, and I kind of really like that. I don't know. It might not be everybody's cup of tea, but I enjoy it. And we're about ready to unlock our third area. So things kind of progress pretty quickly, at least at this point in the game. And you just open more areas, gather more villagers, and generally just kind of, I don't know, like, it's surprisingly fun for how simple I find it. And I've been spending a little too much time playing it, but I can't complain when a game catches my attention more than I expected it to. So the demo is currently available on NextFest, but I don't know if it will be at the time that you're seeing this, but if you'd like to take a closer look, the store page will be linked down below. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider taking a moment to paw that like button, comment to share your thoughts, and subscribe for more mediocre content like this. Until next time, remember, you are perfect just the way you are.